doing daily, surprisingly. And I wanted to make this video on a walkthrough to get to Sheena Reservoir. So I did make a video on Sheena Reservoir. So let me quickly turn the audio down because it's freaking loud. So I wanted to make a video on a Sheena Reservoir, but now I'm going to make a video telling you how to get to a Sheena Reservoir from the very beginning of the game and show you a more in-depth look of it. So what you're going to want to do is this wall jump. So this is basically a walkthrough, and we're already in the Sheena Reservoir. How funny. I think if I just ended the video right now. You got to a Sheena Reservoir now. There's these idiots that are talking. I want you to. Oh! That has never ever in life happened to me. But okay. Can't get me if I'm too fast. So you want to do this ledge hang? I know this video is going to be like an hour long. Hopefully it's not too long. I'll try to speed run it. Try not to fall there. I'm not used to being slow. Alright, so. I have indeed beaten this game. I was literally crying when I beat it because this game is so hard. But if you're starting out, it can hopefully help you. So, you can watch this cutscene, but since I want to get this done, I won't watch the cutscene, but you can watch it. Just don't skip it. Then you have to talk to Kuro and get the healing board. Don't care about this dialogue. Okay, I'm not gonna give her that. So you're probably gonna want to equip the healing gourd because I need to want to use it because you do not have, like, any health, so you definitely don't want to use that, so you can death blow this guy. You will have to fight this guy. These enemies are really, really easy, so just gotta get... Easiest enemy in the game. I beat Ishin. That's gonna be some trouble. I could do Shigenori. Oh yeah, lock on. Lock on. Makes the game easier, literally. If you didn't lock on, that's challenging. Noises they make. Ah! Whoa, I'm gonna die to you. Let's see, can I do Shigenori first try? Oh! Yeah, you might die because you don't have resurrection yet. I'll just skip over to Shigenori. I don't care about the enemies. Okay. I restarted. I didn't want to die much. Not like there's anything to lose. So, you don't have to do these enemies. You could just... Yeah. does not get flinched. This guy's here too, and I don't like it. Okay, I'm just gonna run. You can do this. Ah! It's kind of easier if you die. Oh, God. Oh, God. Yep. So you don't have to fight that guy, but he does give you something. Pellet and pellets restore health. It's not as good as the healing cord, but you know, if you're out of healing cords, then you can use them. So, we're gonna fight a boss. I'll kill this guy first. Now, this boss, I will not spoil anything. This boss is very easy, though, but not for you. For me, he is the commander of the ship. Calm up, whistle. I hate this part because you gotta let crew follow you and it's annoying. Goodbye to cereal. You can watch the cutscenes, but I've already seen them 8,000 times. This is Jenny. You know what? I'm gonna practice preparing. Ah! I forgot. This is not. You need a ability for that move. Well, there you go, your arm's off, and then you have a prosthetic. Just watch the cutscene. So, that was like the beginning. I mean, we're still basically in the beginning, but that was where the game really starts. So, there's a guy over there. Actually, I wanted to test something out. So there's this guy named Hanbei. He... Can he even hit me? Okay, he can. What will happen if I die? Okay. Yeah, you should probably let him do that, because then you'll have resurrection. Yep. Yep. It's taking as long as it would just become just talking. Alright, can I talk? You can do training with him, and if you do all the training, you can get free combat. But I don't know if I really need to tell you that. So, you're gonna rest because you just died. I think you could see it better if I do that, so we'll do that. So you're gonna wanna walk over here and grappling hook you. A lot of grappling hooks you have to jump. I know it's scary, but you just gotta do it. grappling us? You don't, you're fine. So, there's enemies here. They're just like the other enemies, but a little bit harder. So, enemy right there.
Enemy spotted.
Ah! Enemy right there. I'm gonna show you. They're still easy. Not saying they're hard. Then you can, suck and loot. Another enemy right here. The whole patrolling spot right here. So, yeah, you can avoid that. There are a bunch of holes over here. I recommend you get this idol because there's a mini boss here. And that mini boss is a little bit hard. I mean, he's pretty easy, but he's the first mini boss. Anti-air. Sometimes you can get killed by a rooster. Now, I noticed in a lot of people's first playthroughs they didn't do this. It has helped you out a lot. I just fell. Oh yeah, also, you should get this. So, I'm just going to tell you, you can fit a prosthetic tool, but we don't need to do that right now. So, I might do part two, or I might do a whole walkthrough on the game, so you will kind of see you here, but you want to crouch down, and then jump and do an aerial death blow. Okay, that's the Paris talking about. And so, we'll do a sweep, or a thrust. Yep, he's hurting me. Yep, and then there's a safety roll. Oh yeah, that's grab. Ah! Your posture's broken. They're trying to grab you. You just have to dodge that. Gee! Optional because he'll give you this thing called the prayer bead, or if you get four of them, then you will be golden. So yeah, you can look around for the items. I'm not doing a full playthrough. You can get literally all the items. There's a bunch of enemies over here, but you can skip them. Over there, yeah. But you might as well go down here because there is a boss over here. Oh, it's not an actual boss, but it's a mini boss. It's a really hard mini boss. Well, not for me, but for all you, it's a pretty hard mini boss. And so soon we're gonna go over to that house. Well, actually, we might as well go there now before we do the mini boss. Because there's a new area over here. You can talk to this lady, not your son. Then give her the bell. She gives you the bell. So, we'll go ahead the idol, and we'll do some stuff over at the temple. So the bell takes you back into a memory 3 years ago, and it's a pretty cool area. There's a few bosses there. There's an actual boss that I wouldn't recommend fighting, well, yet. Plus, there's a second boss you find. Boss over here. Ah! Yep. It's always the annoyingest jump of 2019. It just seems harder because I don't have like a bunch of attack power and health. So you're gonna want to get this idol. Wah! Yeah, but you do not have 4 prayer beads yet, so you can't do that. But I'm gonna go back to the temple, and you're gonna meet Emma. And she is a doctor, and she will give you more gourds. So, since you killed the general guy, got a gourd seed, and if you find gourd seeds, then you can talk to Emma. She kind of moves around a lot, and she'll give you healing gourds. So. Present. Give you gourd seed. Okay, so now you can listen to that, but it takes a really long time. You're gonna talk to this guy. Oh, okay. Talk to this guy. A lot. Okay, I think I have to do this. So, you can fit prosthetic tools. So this will give you the loaded shuriken. So, you can have 3 prosthetic tools at once. Then you want to do this. So, you put the bell right there, and it'll take you to a new area. Now, we should be in Rada Estate. Secret area. Okay, 3 years ago, Rada Estate, get the idol. Very important. So you want to grapple here because for some reason you die if you drop down. You can talk to this guy who I originally thought was Owl. He is definitely not Owl. He's just a Nightjar. So these enemies are honestly probably easier. Maybe this is hard. The enemy is over in the outskirts. So there's spirit emblems. And that's your like ammo for your prosthetic tools. It costs 1 to throw a shuriken. So the reason we're going here before fighting the mini boss is because you can get another prosthetic here, which will help you a lot. For that mini boss, so what you're gonna wanna do is get this idol. Pick that up. You don't have to do that. So what you're gonna wanna do is you don't need to do that, but you can. There is a guy over there. He's called a pot noble. He'll help you out, and he'll give you some stuff. But you have to go over there and talk to him because I just do not have the patience. These guys are annoying. Just grab the flame barrel and run. Run, run, run. Resurrection, and you might as well open this. Then you're going to run back to to that idol and go to the temple, get the flames, because in this game the people with red eyes do not, they fear fire, so, and this boss has red eyes, so. Go back to the temple. I might as well should put it the shuriken in. So maybe this will be a whole entire walkthrough through the game. But for now, I'm just going to get you to Ashina Castle. So, here we are in Ashina, outskirts at the temple. So if you are having trouble, you can go talk to him. Yeah, so you can get the flame vent. And then equip that, because that's good against this boss. So he is a really hard boss. So the, like I said, the flame gun is really helpful against him. So you're gonna want to go to Harada before fighting him. So is a boss you need Gatine Sugar for. So that makes you half invisible. And that is good, because you can get a death ball on him. Most people don't know this in their first playthrough. Usually they hear about it sometime. But in their first playthrough, most people don't know about this. You can equip these stuff. But what you're going to want to do is death ball this guy. Because it's going to be easier to kill. Alright, so now that you've killed those two guys, you want to use Gatine Sugar. Switch back to your board. They'll be standing right here. And then you get Death Blow on them. So yeah, this is Grabs. Grab you. He likes to grab you. A lot. Kinda just gotta dodge. Grabs. They do a lot of your health, but I wouldn't recommend healing right now. And then if you heal, it'll instantly kill you. So, got him. Dead. So Shinobi Medicine. That gives you more healing. That's good, so. Go back and rest. Rest, because there's another mini boss you're going to want to fight for that prayer bead. You can just ignore these guys. I'm going to grab this. And yeah, grab that. very good. So, this is General Tenzin Yamauchi, my least favorite mini boss, mainly for how much trouble he gave me. I literally had to get my brother. But you're not gonna need prosthetics, so feel free to slice this guy up with your shurikens. So the general's right there. There is some strats on how to do this, but I'm just kind of fighting them. Definitely want to clear these guys before you fight in general. Hey, come here. Move called Breath of Light, which gives you health after you do death blow, but I do not have that right now, so general is right there. Never mind. General is right there. So he is not that hard of a mini boss. Kill him down. Oh, okay. So he's just like that other demo. So you jump over that. I beat up that general so fast. If you die to him, you have to clear out the enemy, so that's why he's kind of annoying. Hey! Whoa, what is about to be sweet. Give you a prayer bead, and you need those prayer beads. So now we're gonna want to do this. We're gonna go travel, go to Harada, because there's a mini boss here that will get you your first prayer necklace that gives you more health. Wait for this crap loading screen. Alright. So you're in Harada. Harada. Wow. So, what you're gonna wanna do? What do you wanna do? Run over here. Open this door. I know it's scary. You think they're gonna hit you, but get the axe. So yeah, that's a prosthetic tool. I don't care about these others. I would recommend you get the McHugh counter for this guy, because he really likes doing the thrust attacks, but I just do not have the time. arching guy will. Arching? He'll hit you. He'll hit you, that's for sure. Shurikens at him. Shurikens. Okay, so this guy's not that hard if you have him as the Makiri counter, which lets you stomp. Can block them. I might actually die to this guy because he's a pain in the butt. If he does not have other enemies, so this is wasting time. So I think darn it. It's gonna take a while to get my Kiwi counter now. You do wanna kill this guy though. Are supposed to be fun. This guy does not make fun at all. So yeah, you gotta kinda get this going fast. Without the Makiri counter, so what you're gonna want to do is get 2 skill points. I'm just killing enemies yet again. Yeah. So now that you have 2 skill points, it's not that hard to get, but living is super annoying to get skill points. You're gonna wanna travel back to the temple and then tell this guy, oh my gosh, I have skill points, so what do I do with it? Okay, you can get skills. Now gives you the shinobi skills that he probably mastered. So you're gonna, you don't have to get 2 skill points to get it, but Whirlwind Slash is not better than the 2 counter. So yeah, skills. Acquire, do not get this. Not get this. Now I do want to acquire my 3. So now that end the Shinobi Hunter mini boss I died to is gonna become like literally easier. Easy. Can become easy. Alright. We can do this. We can do this. I don't think I'm gonna kill this though. There's another mini boss, but I'll kill him in my second part of the walkthrough. Maybe come tomorrow? Maybe? Okay, so. Here. I need to process. I don't know what I'm doing right now. How did nobody do that? Yay! This is great. This is going great. Remember to put that prosthetic in because I forgot. Okay, it just kind of ran away. I'm gonna really not walk onto the archer. Like a man. Alright, so now that stealth blow, put the stealth blow on this little monk. Little bad boy. Okay. See how much easier it is? So now you've got your last prayer beat. Alright, so not that. Enhance. So you've got so loud. Okay, so you wanna go back to outskirts under Bridge Valley. ASMR while the loading screen goes. Well, if you have red eyes, then you are cool. I mean, you're not really that cool. Alright, so. This is a scary part. Now, you're probably not expecting this, but. Probably not part of the screen shake. This. Yeah, there's a snake here. is a snake. And he's kind of freaky. But that's enough. You would normally hide in those bushes, but they're not storing this one. Okay. So right there now. Like, hey, where are you at? Hug the wall. And then be right here. I know there's a way to come up. Go so fast. Okay, so now the palanquin. There's a snap secret over there, but you can get that because once you do leave this place, the snake will be gone. So now, I think I did it wrong, but okay, there we go. He's like, I see you in there, and then you go, bleh! Then you want to get out of here super fast. Stop right here. Dodge. Epic dodge. Yep, and then you have escaped. You escaped the giant snake. Now there's an idol right here that you're definitely gonna want. It's gonna be a gutching. Now this is our first actual boss. Has big horse. My name is Papa Anya. Now he is pretty hard. I'm gonna try to do the cheese. First try. Man, a spear, and a horse. But do not fear because he's very easy. Hey, now get back here. So it's kind of just like, he'll hit you with a spear and you have time to get hit. So far the only time I got hit is by the freaking horse. Oh, he's not that hard. You can get firecracker prosthetic, and that'll make him easier, but... he is a little bit different in the second phase. They don't get that. When I try to fight him, he doesn't hit. Thank you.
be aggressive.
Okay.
He's kind of a cheater.
There. And just like that. So he's a boss because he has a finisher as well. Reflection, yeah, you can fight bosses again in the reflection, so. I'm not sure if I have enough. Let's see, do I have enough? Do I even have purses now? So yeah, he has these firecrackers that are really good. More importantly, you're gonna wanna talk to this dude. He is the owner of the team. Isn't he? Okay. So now, you're gonna wanna run over here. Gonna be like la la la. So you're gonna want to get this eyeball, and I'll show you what memories are. I think the game pro is gonna show you. So enhancing attack power, which reflection you can fight him if you want to can. But enhance. So if you ever get a memory, you need to get the remnant and enhance the attack power. Oh. All right, so this guy's gonna be here like, I wanna shoot you. And you're gonna be like, no, you're not gonna shoot me. You're not gonna shoot me. Yes, I am gonna shoot you. Then he dies. So what you're gonna wanna do? I'm pretty sure you can just death blow this idiot. So annoying. And run over here. Run, 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 run. I'm surprised the video hasn't been an hour yet. We're already almost to Machine Reservoir. Run, run. Okay, so. Talk to this guy. So, I give you the Sheena one. And that is good because you're probably going to get me. Why? Because you have to do this quest in order to progress in the game, and the stuff in there is kind of good. So, there's different types of skills you can get. You can get the Ashina, you can get the Shinobi, you can get the Senpu Temple, the Mushin. So there's the Ashina, Shinobi, Temple, and Mushin. Hold on. Hold on. So, what you definitely want to do is climb up here. Because there's some bats over there. Castle. So we're already basically in Shin Castle. This is a very hard main boss. Most people have a lot of trouble with it, but I got a little tip for you. So, okay, he's a bull. Big bull. You're gonna hit the bull. Run around for yourself here, because not do that. So run, run, run. Run away. I don't know why this guy's still here. Yep, that must have been painful. Think of that annoying. Alright, so yes, bull. Very hard. A lot of people have to deal with this. But we will get him. We will get him. So you do lose half of your skill points and coins. It is annoying. And I don't want to alert all those enemies, so I'm just going to run up here and get there without alerting all the enemies. Alright, so. Yeah, you didn't immediately look over there. You're just like, what? What is that? Am I just about to be killed? So you can see some flames. Five red flames. I don't know why. Medicine. Okay. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh frick. Oh frick. frick, our bull is dead. Our bull is dead. We're gonna die now. And you killed my friend. I kill you now. There you go. Okay, so now we're gonna go to Sheena Reservoir and fight the two mini bosses, and then the video will be over. So this is gonna be about an hour long. So, what you wanna do? Fall. I thought there was a way I could do this. Oh yeah, there's a breakaway. Not right there. There's time wasting. Breakaway right there. And then right there. So, I'm first gonna show you. You know what? You should probably go walk. I'm going to show you the real way to get to Sheena Reservoir. Go right here, and go down here, open this. Sekiro's not strong. Then right here, this is a better way to do it, because I know if this opens, you can escape from the Sheena Reservoir Island. That's just an easy way to get there. So get the Sheena Reservoir. Ah! So, first gonna fight the Lone Shadow. Quickly, I'm gonna check how many herbs they have. Okay. So now we're in the reservoir. Aw, I shouldn't have. Alright. So, I kind of did this as stupid. I made that video at a stupid time in the game. There's a guy here. You can talk to him. Do whatever. I have started a new fresh game so I can make this video. And so he's down there and you just fall down. Come on. Faster. So this guy is nowhere near. That's how hard it is. Yeah. Next mini boss we're gonna fight, because I may die to him. I probably will if I die to the Shinobi Hunter, because he's another spear guy. It is 7 Ashina Spears. I'm gonna rest because the freaking kick, it hurts. Rest. So, I know there's a faster way to do it, but you are gonna have to fight another enemy with him. So, you're going to want to go the same route as we did at the very start of the game. I have to fight this guy at full health because I'm not sure I'm going to live. It almost kills you immediately. So, enter here, death ball them. He's usually not. And there's no Shiganori here. There's a spear in there, but you have to get the key by killing the spear guy on the bridge, and I'll show you that in the next episode. I'll show you a lot more in the next episode. Oh! Darn it. You gotta death blow that guy, because if you go the other route, then that guy will see you. Okay. I'm pretty sure that's the faster one. So remember this? Whoa, I need that jump. Gonna go in here. I'm gonna stand in here like, I am the greatest. I am the hardest mini boss in Sekiro because he probably is the hardest mini boss in Sekiro. So, concentrating. Whoa. So, best tips, aggression, see how much easier it is if you're aggressive, have to be super aggressive, but I beat him and now he's just sliding down, I'm like, yay, I'm dead. So, this would originally be the way that you do it, but when we get back. Shizumi. Like, step on me. Easy. Alright, so. That is it for this video. I really hope you enjoyed. I will be making another walkthrough video on tomorrow, and I don't know how much progress I'm going to make, but I will be making a few of these episodes now that I think about it. So, I really hope you enjoyed this video. Remember to be the best. Bye. Peace.